Hi everyone, today we will try solving problems in Christian law of inheritance. We know that section 29 to 49 in Indian Succession Act 1925 deals with intestate rules for Indian Christians. So today we will solve some of the problems with the help of those provisions. I've already created videos detailing for those provisions. If you do want to learn, please do go visit there. Today let's get started. So intestate is a person who died without making a will. So after his death, his property will be devolved based on the provisions from section 29 to 49. I have created all those provisions in a single table so that you can easily understand. The first person who gets the property is widow or widower. So the rules for the widow and widower are the same. Their share will be 1/3 if lineal descendants are there, or 1/2 if kindreds are there. If no one is there, the entire estate will be shared by the widow or widower. So the next one is lineal descendants. If they are surviving in the same degree, then the division is per capita, and in different degrees the division is per stripes. Their share would be 2/3 if widow or widower is alive, and if no one is there, so if no widow or widower, then the entire estate will be shared by the lineal descendants themselves. Next one is kindred. So if no one is alive in lineal descendants, then only the share will, property will go to kindred. So if father is there and widow is alive, so after deducting widow share, as we have seen 1/2, then the property would be, rest of the property 1/2 goes to father. Similarly, if no father is there, then the property will go to mother. So if mother and brothers and sisters are there, then mother has to share the property with brothers and sisters. So if no father, no mother, and no widow or widower, the entire property will be shared by the brothers and sisters equally. So if there are any one deceased brother or sister, then their children will get their property on behalf of their parents. So if no one is alive, so no widow, widower, no father, mother, lineal descendants, brothers and sisters, then the property goes to near kindred and they will share the property equally. So what you need to remember here is, if lineal descendants are present, then the property won't go to kindreds. Only in the absence of lineal descendants, the property will go to kindreds. Kindreds are father, mother, brothers and sisters. They are said to be kindreds. So if widow is present, then after deducting the widow share, the property devolves either to lineal descendants, and in absence of lineal descendants, it goes to kindred. So now let's see the first problem. An Indian Christian dies living, two sons and two daughters. So let's assume A is the Indian Christian who died intestate, and he survived by two sons, S1 and S2, and two daughters, let's say D1 and D2 are the daughters. So here they are lineal descendants and they belong to the same degree, that is first degree. So the division is per capita as per the tabular column, and per capita is that each will share the property equally. So total number is 4 members. So each will get 1/4. That is how the division. The next one is, A dies leaving property of the net value of 3 lakhs. He survived by his widow and son. So A, the intestate, survived by widow W and son S. And now, since the lineal descendant son is present, the widow share is 1/3. If no lineal descendants, if kindred is there, then widow share is 1/2. Here widow share is 1/3 and rest 2/3 will go to son. So widow share is 1/3 of 3 lakhs is 1 lakh. Remaining 2 lakhs, that is 2/3 of 3 lakhs, will go to the son. So the widow share is 1 lakh and son share is 2 lakh. This is how you have to divide. So the next problem, A Christian leaves 8 grandchildren and 2 children of a deceased grandchild. So there was no one present in first degree, only he survived by 8 grandchildren. Let's say from GS1 to GS8 or 8 grandchildren and 2 children of a deceased grandchild. So one more grandchild, GS9, and he is survived by his children GS91 and GS92. So here there are no one in first degree, only he is survived by grandchildren and great grandchildren. So here the lineal descendants are present in first degree and second degree. So they are in different degrees. So if they are in different degrees, the division is per stripes. So per stripes is nothing but each grandchildren will get 1/9. So total grandchildren are 9. So each will get 1/9. So this GS9 predeceased his father. So what happens is this 1/9 will go to the entire branch of that GS9. So 1/9 will be shared by GS91 and GS92. So 1/9 divided by 2 is 1/18. So GS91 is 1/18. GS92 is 1/18. This is how first stripe calculation is happened. So the next problem is a Christian dies leaving a widow, 2 sons and 2 daughters. So widow W and 2 sons S1. S2 and daughters D1 and D2. So they are all lineal descendants of the same degree. So if lineal descendants are present, the share of widow is 1/3. So here 2/3 will be shared by all the lineal descendants. So here total 4 members are there, S1, S2, D1 and D2. So this 2/3 will be shared by these 4 members. So 2/3 divided by 4 is 2/12, that is 1/6. So S1, S2, D1, D2 each will get 1/6. So if you want to make the denominator same even for the widow share, you can do it by 1/3 into 2/2 is 2/6. So the widow share is 2/6. Rest S1, S2, D1, D2 each will get 1/6 share. So the next problem, a Christian woman died, leaving her husband, father, mother, 3 granddaughters through first predeceased son and 1 grandson through second predeceased son. Let's say A, the Christian woman. So here woman dies, so the husband also have the same rights as the wife, because we already saw that widow and widower have the same rights. So she left her husband H and father, mother M and F, and 3 granddaughters through first predeceased son. So let's assume S1 is the predeceased son and S2 is the another predeceased son. So S1 left 3 children, G1 D1, G1 D2, G1 D3, and S2 left 1 son. So that is S1 and S2 are predeceased, they are no more. So only A is left with 4 grandchildren through predeceased son and son 2. So the share would be, the husband will get 1/3. So remaining 2/3 goes to the lineal descendants, since they are in the same degree. So the division is per capita. So father and mother, they won't get the property because lineal descendants are present here. If there is no lineal descendants, then the property goes to father and mother. Since lineal descendants are present and they are in the same degree, we will share the 2/3 property equally to them. So again, there are 4 grandchildren and they are on the same degree. So 2/3 divided by 4 is 2/12. That is 1/6. Each will get 1/6. So this is how you need to distribute the property. So in this case, in the same problem, if lineal descendants are not present, the husband will get 1/2 property and mother won't get the property because father is there. So remaining half will go to father. Thank you so much for listening. If you find it useful, please share it with your friends. And if you have any doubts, please do ask in comment section. Thank you.